Concrete can be transported by a variety of methods and equipments. The precaution that is needed to be taken while transporting concrete is that the homogeneity which is obtained at the time of mixing the ingredients of concrete should also be maintained while it is being transported and placed to its final place of deposition. So today in this video, we are going to discuss the different methods of transportation of concrete over large and small distances. Now first, let us see what are the types. So first we have the mortar pan, we have wheelbarrows through which we can transport concrete. We have cranes, buckets and ropeways. Then we can also transport concrete by the help of truck mixers and dumpers, belt conveyors. We can use chutes, skips and hoists. And last but not the least, the most widely accepted or widely adopted method of transportation of concrete is by the use of transit mixers and pumps and pipelines. And lastly, which is remotely used, is a helicopter. Well, now let's see the each one of these methods and types. So first here, this is a picture which is showing, this picture is basically a mortar pan. So this is nothing but a bucket which is attached to a rider. And this bucket is always able to carry very small quantities of concrete. So the concrete is basically poured in this bucket and the rider to which it is attached will transport the concrete. So in case of mortar pans, concrete which is carried is in very small quantities in these buckets. Now, while this method nullifies the segregation of concrete to some extent, but because a greater surface area of concrete is already being exposed in this bucket, so this exposure of concrete to very dry or very hot weather leads to the drying up or stiffening of concrete. So carrying or transporting concrete in such buckets or even in wheelbarrows is quite disadvantageous because it often leads to the stiffening of concrete in the long run. Now, mortar pan method of conveyance can be used for concreting at ground level, below the ground level, or maybe sometimes even above the ground level. Next, we have a wheelbarrow, which is somewhat similar to that of the mortar pan. In this wheelbarrow, we have this bucket here, which is used for transporting the concrete. Now, it is attached to one wheel here. So, wheelbarrows are also normally used for transporting concrete that is to be placed at ground levels. Okay, so the next picture we have here is that of a crane. Okay, and a bucket of concrete is being attached or is being hanged from this crane. So a crane and a bucket is one of the right equipments for transporting concrete above structures which are above the ground level. So cranes and buckets are very fast, they are very versatile, and they are also able to move concrete horizontally as well as vertically in case of high-rise buildings, in case of concrete bridges, and also it allows the placement of concrete at the exact points. Okay. Now, sometimes the crane might not be there. We can also transport concrete with the help of only ropes and buckets. So ropeways and buckets are also used for transporting concrete to places where very simple methods like that of wheelbarrow or mortar pans are not able to transport the concrete at the required locations. Okay, so this crane, buckets and ropeway, these methods can be easily transport the concrete to places where at very remote locations where simple methods of transportation of concrete is not feasible. Next, we have the trucks, mixers and dumpers. So these are particularly used for transporting concrete in large concrete construction works after mixing the concrete in these trucks. Okay, next we have the belt conveyors. As you can see, concrete is being transported on this belt conveyor over large distances. So belt conveyors, they have a very limited applications in concrete construction. The concrete which is in this belt conveyors, they have a tendency to segregate on very steep inclines or at transfer points or even when there is a change in direction. Okay, so apart from that concrete is also being exposed to the dry weathers. Okay, concrete is also being exposed over these long stretches, and this might also lead to the drying out or stiffening of concrete in very hot and dry and windy weather. And apart from drying or stiffening of concrete, segregation might also take place due to the vibration of the rubber belts, which are enabling the belt to transport the concrete over large distances. Now, next we have the picture of a chute here, which is basically an inclined transporter. So this is an inclined container through which concrete is being poured, and these chutes are used for transporting the concrete from some upper level or from some higher level to a lower level. So chutes are generally provided for transporting concrete from ground level to a level which is lower than the ground. Next, we have the skip and hoist. Now, the picture of the skip and hoist is not provided here. I will ask you to look up the picture from Google. So, skip and hoist is one of the, again, a very widely adopted methods of transporting concrete. And it is generally used for transporting concrete vertically upwards for multi-story buildings. Okay, so next we have the transit mixer. Now, as all of you know, that it is one of the most popular equipments for transporting concrete over long distances, particularly in ready mixed concrete plant. Okay, so this is basically a truck on which a concrete mixer is being mounted. Now, there are over 600 transit mixers operating in India currently. And the transit mixer, which is mounted on the truck, has a capacity of about 4 to 7 meter cubes. There are two variations. In one, the mixed concrete is being transported to the site by keeping this concrete mixer agitated all along at a speed varying between 2 to 6 revolutions per minute. And in the other category of transit mixer, the concrete is being first batched at a central batching plant, and then mixing is done in the truck mixer, either in transit, that is during transportation, or the mixing is done immediately prior to discharging the concrete at the site. Sometimes what happens, a small concrete pump is also mounted on this truck. Okay, so this pump will pump the concrete to the destination site. The concrete which is being discharged from the transit mixer gets pumped to the destination site. So next we have the pumps and pipeline. So the pumping of concrete is universally accepted as one of the main methods of concrete transportation and placing. So this is basically a pipeline through which concrete is being discharged to the required destination or the required location. Now, concrete gets pushed through this pipeline, and this is known as pumped concrete or pumpable concrete. So it is written here, pumpable concrete is the concrete which is being pumped through a pipeline. Hydraulic piston pump is the most widely used modern type of pump in case of pumping the concrete. The correct pump which is being discharged from the pipe depends on the following factors. So it will depend on the length of the horizontal or the vertical pipe which is being used for pumping the concrete. Then it also depends the bends of the pipes which is there. Okay. Next, we have the diameter. The diameter as well as the length, both are very important. These factors are very important in discharging or pumping the concrete. Then we have the length of the hose and the changes in line diameter. And also the slump or the ease with which concrete is being worked, that is the workability of concrete, is another factor which is involved or which enhances the pumping action of concrete. So that's it, guys. In the next videos, we will be coming up for the methods that is used for placing and what are the precautions that needs to be taken while placing concrete. Then we will also discuss about the different methods of compacting concrete as well as curing concrete. So until then, see you. Goodbye.